Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back, and we're here at the Sanctuary. I know it's been a while since I've uploaded. I did mention in the last couple of my videos, I think, that I would be absent for a little while, and you know, it's just mainly because I had some studying priorities and stuff to attend to. So anyway, we're here at the Sanctuary, and what we're doing here is basically building a new Mayor's House 2.0, okay? But this is just mainly for the Sanctuary, because a lot of people have been asking me, how do you build on the Sanctuary house blocks, and how do you build houses there, and how come I haven't uploaded anything from the Sanctuary? And that was just mainly because, I guess, you know, back when I built on the Sanctuary, I was building crappy, shitty little junk towns, okay, which I didn't really want to upload. Because, you know, I don't really think I need to show you guys how to build that kind of stuff. So anyway, here we are, and this is it's a pretty basic build, okay? There's nothing really complex about it. It probably looks a little more complex than what it is. I've had to add, you know, a few decorations here and there to kind of brighten it up a little bit, because I wasn't able to mix and match as many prefabs as I wanted to, in order to keep the kind of theme for the place. So, I got a little side power unit on the side of the house here. This is just basically if you have any need to turn your power off. I don't really think you need to, but I mean, Bethesda's given us the option, so I don't know, maybe it might come in handy one day. And you know, if we go up the top here, obviously we got the elevator on the back side here, and then I haven't furnished up top here yet, but I have kind of started furnishing the little outdoor deck area at the side here, which gives us quite a nice little view of the Sanctuary when you think about it, okay? And one mainly being the bridge, which is, you know, one of the most, well, probably biggest hotspots for enemy spawns. So still a work in progress at the moment. I did promise a few people a 2.0 Mayor's House build, so that's what this is for. However, because I'm basically rebuilding or upgrading the Sanctuary original build, you know, obviously I'm going to bring out a few more just Sanctuary house builds and, you know, repairing the Sanctuary houses and stuff like that. So, up top here is just a trophy room. Not very important. You can really turn it into whatever you wanted. I just kind of wanted to keep my room downstairs on the second floor. And so, yeah, it's a pretty basic build. I guess I'm more trying to get the idea across here, because a lot of people have asked, you know, how do you build Sanctuary houses and stuff like that? And, you know, off the original Sanctuary house blocks, you know, it's very hard to build an actual house out of these new prefabs from the Contraptions DLC and, you know, the Far Harbor DLC and stuff like that. So, I guess obviously you're just building your own foundations and you're building bigger foundations. That's how it seems to be the easiest way for me to do it. Unless you're going to build out of the, you know, the older prefabs from the vanilla set. Let's go ahead and let's get started. So first things first is we're going to build our base foundation, okay? So obviously we need it a little bigger than the original vacant ones in the Sanctuary here. So what I've done is just place my foundations around the outside. You don't have to do this. I just find it a little bit easier. And this just allows me to grab another foundation of the same type, and we're basically just going to place it parallel to our corner one just here. Okay, and it just has to be one tile high. That just allows us to build over the top of the original foundation here. And then all we have to do is just pretty much pop these up. Okay, so we just keep building our way across, and then we can just pop these up like so. Now, I think it's probably gonna be around about 7x6 from what I remember. Okay, so not entirely sure. If you have troubles here with the bushes, okay, all you have to do is basically just get a little bit below it, and you'll find that you'll be able to make it snap in. Okay, you don't have to go to the bush line if you don't want to. Obviously we're just going to keep building our foundation around. Gotta be careful not to build these too big, okay, especially if they're really high off the ground. It does start to look a little strange after a while, as you'll see towards the back here, as I think we're probably hanging probably a bit higher than the ground at the back here, so I'll show you how to fix that very shortly. Now, should make sure we get the right dimensions here. And yeah, so as you see down the back here, we're kind of just sort of floating in the air there. So all we need to do is just put a wall on, and then we can snap a foundation underneath, okay? And you should be able to do this either side. Some of them you might not be able to, I'm not sure. You need a certain amount of space. So anyway, and then what we're gonna do now is we're obviously just gonna put our floors in. So to do this, we're just doing the dropping technique. I would've taught a lot of yous in one of my recent videos, or a few of my recent videos. So we just do this by taking our, just placing our floor up the top here, and then we're just gonna place this back in like so. We drop this down, and if it's red when you hit the ground, okay, all you gotta do is just jump up in the air and then just tap X, or you know, the select button on whatever platform you're on. So now we have that placed perfectly above the foundation below it. So now we can basically just build the rest of our floors. Now I think we probably want about maybe 3 in width from front to back. We might try 4 for now. And then obviously, yeah, you just want to go completely from left to right. So it should be about 7 across and 4 to the back. So yeah, 7 across and 4 from the front to the back. But I think it might actually be 3. But anyway, we'll just try this for now. And of course, we're only just putting these in because we need to put walls on, stuff like that. And it's just much easier to have an actual floor below it rather than use the foundation itself. So now we need to build our front sort of patio section. And so we've got a nice little storm coming in. I think I was right. I think we actually only want about 3. And then what we can do is just build another row of foundations at the back. Okay, this is just going to allow us to work around this bush here, which is a little bit of a pain. But it shouldn't be too much of an issue. So we want 3 in the dead center. Okay, you're going to have 2 blocks either side. And what we will do is we'll just put another set of foundations down the back here. Okay, now in order to do that, obviously we're going to have to get rid of one of the floors up here where you can snap it together, and then we just snap these the whole way across. And then use the same trick we used before to put the foundations below it. Okay, now that's done. I'll go back up top here, finish the floors up the top, and yeah, so we've still got our 4 now, but we have our 3 at the front here as well. So now we can begin with the base structure, and we're just basically going to put these very large windows at the front here, okay, because it is a mayor's house and you want to kind of add some nice windows to the front and sides. We're going to put our doorway in. First, we're just going to pull this out, and that way we can snap that one in. So we'll just start building our front entrance here. And so what we're going to do is just build it inwards, okay? We have a little balcony on the second floor, and then we're going to have a little kind of design roof at the front there, which, you know, you generally see in a lot of mayor's houses, you know, like in the, I guess, the modern day. Yeah, this can be a little bit tricky sometimes because these prefabs are just the worst sometimes. They just do not go where you want them to go. So what you will find is that if you kind of use your triggers or your rotation button, whatever platform you're on, and you just kind of tap them, sometimes they just go exactly where you want them to go, or sometimes they just be just a complete pain. So obviously this is our second floor up here. We have a little balcony up there. We're going to put some more windows on the front here, okay, because it's going to be on the bottom and the second floor. We have these big, large windows here. And then what we'll start doing is putting some supports in here, because this is that, that weird kind of little roof thing that you see on a lot of, American-style air houses. This is a little bit of improv here, so it's not going to look perfect. But it should look all right. And now what we want to do is put our roof in. So if we cycle all the way back, you really just use any wall, it doesn't matter. Just using the wall to snap the roof up the top, our roof prefab. And then we're just going to go ahead and do that on the opposite side. Okay, you only need to do one. Just place that up there like so. And then once you've done that, you can place the other ones behind it. Okay, now this is that kind of weird archway, I guess, you see on a lot of you know, really important kind of houses. And then we're just going to put these corner pieces up here. Don't worry about doing the backside because we're actually going to need to put roof pieces in there, and I'll show you what we're going to do with that a little bit later on. This should just add a little bit of just a little bit of design, I guess, to the front face of the house. And you know, as you can see when we get inside, it's a very basic design. Other than the front of the house, it's really, really basic. So just finish this off here, and then we might move inside. I think it was my last video where I had like the really bad audio issues, and I mean, I couldn't work out for so long what actually happened there, but it was something to do with like the equalizer on my Elgato audio thingy. So yeah, I mean, it worked out fine on my computer, but not so good for everyone else. And yeah, which is kind of actually really annoying on my end too, because you know, I went to the effort of making this 30-35 minute video with audio and editing, and just found out that, you know, nobody could hear me. So yeah, I mean, hopefully I can redeem myself from that, and hopefully there's no more audio issues from here on in. I still do have the occasional issue with my mic for some reason, but yeah, it's not really a big issue at the moment. But yeah, I mean, like, I did get, you know, quite a bit of negative feedback there, which is understandable. But yeah, I mean, like I said, I really, it sounded fine on my computer, so there was no way of me actually knowing. You know, software tends to update itself sometimes, and then that causes issues. So anyway, we seem to be getting somewhere now. We're getting pretty much the base structure up. We're just going to put some walls up, and actually, this probably it's probably going to look quite plain right now, because what I'm going to do is actually just run around, and I'm just basically just going to put these same walls up over and over. Okay, because I'm going to put my windows and everything in a little bit later on. Just for now, I just kind of want to get the shape up and start working out, you know, I guess the architecture of the rooms and the main entrance and stuff like that. So just get us some better lighting, and we'll just keep going. So go all the way towards back here. Just remember that in line with our doorway is going to be our elevator, so we can just leave that open for now. And then once we're done with that, we may as well just put our elevator in for now. So I'm using the 3-floor elevator, which is all we need. You could put a 4th floor in, so maybe you could, you know, drop you down the back there as well. That's completely up to you. You see doors for the elevator, so just looks a little bit like an elevator. And then now what we'll do is we'll go around and just put our floors in. So I put our floors in now, and I'm just going to use these as well. I'm going to mix and match these a little bit later on. I mean, if you're a little bit worried about resources and stuff like that, and you don't want to use unnecessary prefabs, I mean, of course, you can just go through and mix and match them as you're going. Not too worried about the resources myself. I have quite a large supply on Spectacle Island. That's kind of why I'm just speed building right now. And yeah, I can't really remember exactly how this build went, to be honest, so that's why I'm just kind of trying to get the bulk up for now, and working out the little bits and pieces later on. So and you know, it's kind of very similar to my County Crossing build, the mansion build I built there. You got your grand entrance in the middle with your, you know, balconies around the top, and you know, stuff like that. It's because it's quite common in buildings like this, so I'm sticking to that same kind of design. Of course, it's still going to be a little bit different. Obviously, I'm going to try and mix and match a few more prefabs, because we've got a lot of the same kind of prefabs going on right now, and we don't want that later on. So, just for now, just going to finish off the frame. So, we're going to have two kind of rooms either side here, and just leading to a kind of main entrance way, and then the same thing down below. So, we'll do now is just put our roofs in. Okay, so we don't want to go that way. We want to go, so we want to face towards the front and the back. Okay, So you just run these all the way along the back here, as far as we can to the elevator just here. And same thing the other side, and then we should do the same at the front. And now all that's left is pretty much we're just gonna put our ceilings in. So we need to cover up these ugly roof pieces, so we're just gonna put flat ceilings in all the way through, okay? And then by the time we get to the top, we should, you know, we should be pretty much finished. So once yours is looking like this, you just want to go ahead. Actually, we'll just fill in these walls here real quick, and just put a couple of these half pieces in, and then of course just a couple of the corner pieces in the left and right. So just switch them around. And once that's done, then all we need to do is, yeah, just go ahead and put our ceilings in. So these flat pieces here, which we used at the front just earlier, we're just gonna run these all the way across. You can put floor pieces in here if you want. They fit in perfectly. I just think these look a little bit better and just a little bit different. So you add that little extra to it. So now we're getting there, okay? It's almost finished. In the way of the base structure, I guess. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just finish this. I guess it's just like a little sort of balcony setup in the main entrance here. And I'm just kind of mixing and matching a few of these railings. Okay, I'm not going overboard with it. There's no need to. Just keep just a little bit of variety in there, but you know, without it looking kind of too silly. Now I'm gonna pull my walls in this way here, because I want to try and get this flush and hard up against the staircase. And should be able to get some doors in the back here. It's looking good. Yeah. And then of course we're just gonna have to pull this front section back just a touch. Okay, just so I can shut that gap off there. You could always fill it in however you wanted, if you like. I just find this a little bit easier. And yeah, it just kind of brings in that a little bit further. Pretty happy with that so far. Okay, so now, of course, obviously we need to do something about this elevator, because it's kind of floating in mid-air, and we don't want that, so gonna do is gonna place one of these in, and then we're just gonna go ahead and place one underneath. Okay, it doesn't have to be perfect. It'd be quite hard to get it perfect, actually. If you can just get in there as best as you can, I'm sure there's a few other alternatives you could do there. Now I'm just gonna place my sort of power unit or generator around the side here, side of the elevator. In my original build, I placed it around underneath the balcony. But however, because I've built the extra room around the side, that's going to be a little bit difficult. So just placing these in as supports. Okay, they're not super easy to get in sometimes, but play around a little bit. There we go. Okay, so we'll just place our fusion generator on the top here. Fusion generator might be a little bit overkill. You know, I just figure, you know, they're actually really good to have in any structure. So and then yeah, I should go ahead and box this in a little bit. The reason I do this is because, you know, I have heard you know, bad things about people attacking settlements and stuff like that, and they can actually destroy your generators, or synths can, you know, turn them off and stuff like that. I don't know, you know, just extra added precaution. I usually just box it in, and I don't seem to have any troubles. So we'll just place in a conduit around the side here, and that way we can just connect our elevator straight to the fusion generator. And then just place our screen back on. And then now just a few finishing little touches on the back here. So we're just gonna use these glass windows in order to give it that kind of glass elevator kind of appeal. And we'll go back up to the top, and we'll find ourselves in our trophy room here. So you know, you can make this as big as you like, really. I didn't make mine too big, because I think if you make it too big, it kind of looks a little funny. from down the bottom. So I'm just going in maybe two blocks each side here, and then I'm just going to build myself a room in the middle. Okay, just by using these half walls, very simply just placing them underneath, and I should do that all the way around. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to use the glass window half walls. Okay, we're going to place them at the top. So we just go ahead and find them. There they are. And then we'll place these all the way around. Okay, it's just going to... I mean, we could put windows in there normally, but then we'd be seeing the outside roof and it would just look a little funny. So we'll place these ones, though. We can place these ones in the side here. And place that one back in the top. Put our doorway back in. And then, same as we did on the second floor, we're just going to place our ceiling pieces in just to give us that flat roof. And then, of course, yeah, we're just going to go on the outside and we're just going to place some actual roofs on the top just to finish it. So I use these corner pieces here. They're really handy, especially for these smaller kind of roof pieces. And place them either side, which will just leave a gap in the middle where we can use two normal pieces, prefabs, to just place in the middle right there. Okay, just continuing through, we're just gonna just put maybe one of these top of the elevator here. And it's not looking too bad. So we're pretty much on the home stretch here. There's still a lot of, decorations and stuff like that. With the center of the roof, this front sort of section here, you can put one of these in, or you can just keep it flat. I don't really know sort of what I'm feeling right now, but I'm just going to leave that for now. And just go ahead and just start doing some little finishing touches like mixing, matching prefabs, putting some windows in and stuff like that. Obviously you want to do this both sides, so go ahead and, you just do what you want here. I don't like to give you guys everything because, I like to see what you guys can do with, a particular build and like the base build, and then, see what you guys come up with, or, if you're here for just ideas, like it's all the same. So now what we're doing is we're going to build that extra room. Okay, now I did build a balcony here. You don't have to build the room on the side here if you don't want. I just found it a little more convenient to have the balcony there because this room kind of became irrelevant eventually, and I think the mayor's house is big enough as it is, so like I said, it's completely up to you guys. Now we run this way around, and what we do is we're going to place our wall in so we can go up top and start placing our railings in. Okay, now the reason why I place the railings in first is because once you place the walls in, you can't place the railings up the top. Well, you can, but they don't snap, so just keep that in mind. Just go up and put your railings in while it's just floating in the air, and then just go back down the bottom and we can place our walls in. So put our doorway in first, and down the bottom here we're just going to place our walls in like so. Now I'm just using the glass window ones here. Okay, this could be a trophy room also if you wanted. Now we're really on the home stretch. So I've just added a few of my own little decorations. Okay, I always do this probably midway or towards the end, just to see kind of where I'm going with the build and how I'm going to finish it. So for now, I'm just going to put a fence in. Now this is just using the concrete because I want to try and mix and match as much as I can, which is quite hard to do with this build. But what I'm doing right now is just kind of moving this back and lining it up with the actual foundation itself, as you can see. So So we just continue to run these around, and God, I forgot how painful these ones were as well. Okay, and then go ahead and do the exact same thing on the other side. Okay, so I'm just creating a guide to move my first wall piece over, get rid of these, and then just keep running these along. And you can really do whatever you want here. I'm doing something just really basic, so I'm just building a full concrete perimeter around the house itself, and then in the center here I'll just go ahead and sort of build myself a bit of a grand entrance, maybe using some of the barn prefabs or something. That's pretty much it. So what you need to do is basically just add some decor, some lighting, etc. And that's pretty much it. It's the base build. I did promise some people a 2.0 version of the mayor's house. I'm sorry it's a little bit late. I've been very busy, very flat out. So, I'm not going to do like a huge sort of series on the sanctuary builds, but I am going to rebuild it from the ground up, with all of the new content, and bring a few more builds out, like sanctuary houses and building onto the sanctuary houses, stuff like that. Overall, we do have mods coming out shortly on PS4, so I want to hopefully get to some mod-created content pretty soon. So that's pretty much a wrap there. I really hope you guys like it, and just please don't forget to drop a like for me if you did. I'm TLK, and I'll see you guys next time.